It's re-tick feeding time, and Jason was just feeding this golden child, and she was too quick for him. So right now we're just feeding some defrosted guinea pigs, and hello. So she's got the hook and the guinea pig, but wow, just so pretty. So I'm in a retic breeding room. These are some habitat cages. They make awesome big snake cages. Had these cages a long time too. These have held up great. So if you look at these cages, you got big. This is an 8-foot cage. So we have, I designed these to have a divider in the middle. So we'll find a cage that's being divided. Right now it's breeding season, so we're trying to give as much room to these girls as possible. There's a big calico. Some schmeg on the glass. Big platinum, big albino. There's a big, normal looking, but she's has something. Here's a big ivory. Now this ivory is shedding. Ugh. Hey baby, she's big. So that's, these cages are, that's a 48 by, I think, 29. So 40 inches by 30 inches roughly. And that is one big snake. Not big by prehistoric pets, big. Jay makes some retics monstrous. But that's a substantial snake. Obviously, I don't want to make them too big when they're in these kind of quarters. Another thing, this is a snake, just finished eating. So this snake is swallowing. So people that are new to snakes swallow their food in one big meal. And their jaw is loosely connected, so they can really take on large food items due to the elasticity of their skin and their tissue. Here's a nice albino. It's a citrus albino, actually. Awesome. All right, here's a... She's, this snake is ridiculous. That's a tiger calico. So that's one of my calicos I made. She's genetic. And the calico gene is pretty weird and tricky. As snakes mature that are carrying the genes, some of them will change as they grow. Like if we go back to big calico here, or that calico right there. All right, here's a divider. Here's a kind of a beet divider. But that can go there. So when you're cleaning the cages, you know, obviously, whenever you manage big snakes, you have to have respect for these guys. And if you just follow some very basic techniques of managing large snakes, they're actually quite simple to deal with. And you don't have to ever experience offering your hand as a mistaken food item, because you're using your brain. And by having a divider like this, you have a big 8-foot cage, I can locate the snake, trap that snake in one side of the cage, clean it, paper it, and then either move it to the other side or just, you know, clean the other side of the cage, just depending what I'm gonna do. It's a platinum tiger right there, nice reading. And right now, this is breeding season. So
We got a cow back there.
I get some. Look at that glottis. So people still don't know snakes. Snakes have this air breathing tube. So as they're basically swallowing food, they will use that to breathe. So it allows them to eat like large meals. Hey, sweetie, I'm gonna take away your inevitable hook. Hey, sweetie, here you go. So her jaw is kind of, she's got this food item caught in her coil against the dish, and then her teeth are hooked on it. If I'm not careful, I'm gonna wake up dead, according to my Megadeth song. Alright, I guess this is just fun with retics. I wonder what the snake is thinking. She's thinking that I'm very rude and obnoxious. You know, I'm always waiting for the day where I'm sitting here. I do these videos, I'm staring through the viewfinder. I'm actually not even looking at the snake, except for, you know, through the camera. There's one point where I'm gonna be staring at the viewfinder. I'm like, oh, where'd the snake go? And all of a sudden, zap. Yeah, her teeth are barely nailing that. All right, I don't know if this video's interesting to anybody, but I gave it a shot. Love your awesome meticulous pythons.